Hello, welcome. Recently, LukeFZ's mod has undergone updates. For those who are not familiar, this mod allows the use of the FSR3 frame generator. In this new update, some notable games have been added, such as Red Dead Redemption 2 and Dying Light 2. Responding to suggestions from some viewers, today I will make a comparison between DLSS, native FSR, and the FSR3 mod. Additionally, I will revisit some games that in the previous version had issues, like Cyberpunk 2077, where FSR3 was not triggered correctly, and Alan Wake 2, which faced crash problems.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Let's start by talking about Red Dead Redemption 2. To make the game work, you will need the latest version of the game. Unfortunately, my game is not up to date, so I won't be able to demonstrate it for you. But in this game, just install the mod and use the FSR2 version, which will be automatically replaced by version 3. Next, the GPU Destroyer, Alan Wake 2. Using DLSS or FSR3 with frame generation, I didn't notice much difference. But if we look at FSR2, the difference is brutal, with almost double the frames. Another notable thing using FSR3 is the savings of almost 2 GB of RAM. During all the tests conducted, the maximum FPS should not be considered because the current version of the overlay has the maximum FPS bug. Even resetting the maximum FPS at the beginning of recording, it will always be displayed at exorbitant values, even if it never reaches such a mark.
Not a bad place to get murdered.
If getting back to nature.
And I managed to set it up correctly in Cyberpunk 2077, and this is where we can see the biggest recorded gain, with FSR3 generating twice the frames compared to DLSS and FSR2. However, here is where I noticed more graphical artifacts. The aliasing became much more evident using FSR3, and the rain particles look strange. No graphical artifacts were noticed in subtitles or the HUD. Dying Light is the new game supported by FSR3. Previously, it had many bugs and was not recommended for use. Now, after the fixes, FSR3, as expected, shows great results. However, something easily noticeable is that it transferred the GPU load to the CPU. Therefore, if you have a CPU that causes bottlenecks in your GPU, it may not be a good idea to use it. In this game, FSR2 outperforms DLSS, with gains that reach more than 30 FPS at times. When comparing FSR2 and FSR3, the gain is more than 40 FPS. Certainly, FSR stands out in this game, even when using Nvidia hardware. Finally, Marvel's Spider-Man, Miles Morales. In the previous video, I already tested the first Spider-Man game. If you want to see it, I'll leave the link in the card for easy access. In this case, the results follow the Nvidia pattern, with FSR2 showing the lowest performance, followed by DLSS and FSR3. The performance of FSR3, at times, is up to 50% higher than DLSS. Again, the compensation of frame generation eases the GPU load and makes the CPU work a little more. If you liked the video so far, don't forget to leave a like to support our work. And if this is your first time, subscribe to the channel. If you are using version 0.10 of the mod, most HUD problems have already been resolved. So if you are still on an old version, I recommend updating immediately to fix issues. Overall, the FPS gain from FSR3 causes additional CPU load, as you may have seen in the previous results. So keep in mind that having a processor causing a bottleneck in the game won't give you FPS gains with FSR3. Hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time. Kill him.